Ladies and gentlemen, this is a story that came out in the New York Times July 1st, 2018. Many of you, including myself, probably didn't even know that emergency rooms all across America are short on drugs, especially pain medication. And they have been scrambling to use different alternatives to things like morphine for patients, and a lot of times those alternatives are not good. You would think this kind of news would have made mainstream media. It hasn't. And the thing is, they said this season, when summer comes, this is when emergency rooms are exceptionally busy because you have people getting into more accidents on bikes, more car accidents occur this time of the year. All types of injuries, and these hospitals do not have enough drugs for their patients. And from what this article is saying, this has been going on for months. They've been short on things like morphine and heart drugs, drugs for people that are having heart problems. They're short on that too. And it's writing about this one hospital in Chicago called Norwegian American Hospital. They said they've been short on morphine since March, but these shortages are actually in small and large hospitals all over the country. Doctors and nurses are scrambling every time someone comes in and looking for an alternative painkiller or heart drug to give the patient. And in some cases, many of these patients with bone injuries, broken bones and stuff, have to leave with no pain medication at all. And they said the problem is real complicated. Now, one of the main suppliers of morphine is Pfizer. Some of you might have heard of that pharmaceutical company. Some plants have lowered their supplies, and some manufacturing plants that put out these drugs won't even make these drugs anymore. So they're running into like a double-edged sword. For years, drug shortages have created a behind-the-scenes scramble as pharmacists, doctors, and nurses. What they try to do is come up with all of these different ways to treat pain. But doctors around the country say the latest shortages are more directly affecting the patient care. A survey in May of emergency doctors in their professional association, the American College of Emergency Physicians, found that 9 of 10 said they didn't have access to crucial medicines. Nearly 4 in 10 said, patients have been negatively affected. Now, the lack of pain medication, yeah, that's a huge problem. You know, especially people that have been in accidents. And they're saying that the root of the drug shortage is complex and seemingly without a simple fix. The vast majority of the products in question are sterile injectable drugs, hospitals, workhorses, and other cheaply priced, even though they can be difficult to make. These low margins have led to some companies stop making the drug, while others have failed to invest older facilities, leading to a host of quality problems, recalls, and plant shutdowns. So they're having a problem at the plant level that actually make the actual drugs. Wow. You would think they would have a plan B, but apparently they don't. And see, the root cause of a lot of this, ladies and gentlemen, a lot of these drugs were actually made in Puerto Rico. So when Hurricane Irma and Maria went through, it literally shut down the pharmaceutical manufacturing that was done in Puerto Rico, which now has caused a major shortage in these hospitals around the country. You would think they wouldn't rely on one source to get these drugs to all of the hospitals nationwide, but apparently that's what's happening. The periodic problems were compounded last fall when Hurricane Maria hit Puerto Rico, a major center of pharmaceutical manufacturing, causing a shortage of small saline bags that are a mainstay in hospitals and worsening a years-long problem with keeping intravenous fluids in stock. So many of these products were made in Puerto Rico. I mean, who knew? Who knew? You know, and what's shocking to me is some of these hospitals have had problems with keeping drugs around since a year ago. You know, and they're just speaking about this now. I mean, you know how dangerous that is? I would think they would be afraid of being sued, but they're having a terrible time trying to replenish their depleted stock of medication, including opioids. Opioids is another thing that the hospitals are having a problem, and also pharmacies getting in stock now. Okay, in May, Pfizer released morphine and other drugs in cracked syringes with instructions to healthcare providers to filter the drugs through injecting them. Wow. Wow. And, you know, after reading this, they still don't have a solution to how, you know, what they're going to do about all these shortages of drugs that are going on. And this person that you're looking at was having chest pains and went to the hospital, but the doctors gave him another opioid and fentanyl and not really the heart medication that he really needed. That's dangerous. You would think they would try to even look overseas and see who can make these drugs. Wouldn't they be in fear of being sued for not being able to treat the patients that come into the emergency rooms? I would think they would be afraid to be sued. But this is what's going on. You know, I hope each and every one of you stay safe and you don't have to end up in anybody's hospital emergency room, especially at this time when there's such major drug shortages going on all around the country. But please tell me what you think, ladies and gentlemen. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I will see you on the next video. And those of you that have supported my channel and became patrons, I thank you. You know, believe me, I see it out there. And I just want you to know, anything you do in support of my channel, I deeply appreciate it. Peace, family.